Hello and welcome to my project Bucket Manager. This is a recording of the live coding session, and here I am developing a JavaFX application for managing XML files, and this is very interesting because I am using TDD. It's another example of the TDD method to develop software. So let me recapitulate with which I have done, what I have done previously. So I have an XML reader class which reads XML documents. In this case I have satellites XML. I'll just draw it like so. It reads a SAT XML document and loads it in the SAT model class object. And set model class have JDOM document as a result of this, and after that set model instantiates satellite information objects. Such as these objects, they are consist all information which was read previously from the satellite XML file. So let me go back to Eclipse and show you something what I have thinking about. So you see here clearly a satellite have a lot of information, and object domain complexity is pretty interesting. I have here a PDF file which describes what should I expect in the attributes of the satellite's XML file. So you clearly see here that my attributes value for flex is numeric, it's probably integer, and the same goes to the position. Let's think about this. Sure, I can check for the ranges. Do I need to do that? Can I postpone this decision? I think sure, I can do this and postpone this decision. What I need to do, I'm thinking about cutting SAT model in another class, so that it can create not one object but two objects. But actually, as I'm going through this XML file, I'm thinking that is tightly coupled information, the satellite name and the accordingly to this the transponder information. So what I shall do, I need to write a test which just allow me to create another field in the SAT information object here. So let me just do this what I'm do, and I need to do following. I need to set up my satellite, and where I can do this, where I'm having the calls. So let me just think it through. So I'm set info object expected result. Alright, so in order to do this, actually I need to do following. Actually I need to write in set model, I need to write a test in set model, because I need to load the information first to SAT model, and after that I can do this with SAT. After that I can do this the test. So I just commented out this code, and my SAT model test, I need to write following: test and I will write here following: read. I expect to read from my satellite's XML two values, flex and position, because both values are integers and I expect to work with integers. But let me do it separately. Read flex from JDOM document. Alright, so let me just do it like this. Now I can write my test. First of all, I would have here actual and expected results. So I think I will just would here do the same stuff like this, and I will do here things like this so that I know, and probably I will put it in the same try and catch, because I don't wish to have an unhandled exception. This is actually not good when it gets to there. But all right, so I have my things. All right, so I just need to write here set model object method. So I will write here load from JDOM document load flex from JDOM document, and this should be like this. So, and I need an assertion, sure. And I write here following. Do this like this. And what I am actually checking if SAT model did loaded like flex values. And let's just create this method. So, and I will do some sort of a mocking, because currently when I'm executing this test case, it did fail. So I do some sort of a mocking, making here true, and I have pass the test. All right. So what I need to do, I need to do following. I have in SAT model following, I have to find the part where I'm reading the value. So as I said earlier, some data structures take time to get it through. Oops. So this is the wrong picture actually. I need this picture. I almost forgot it to include in my workspace. So now we have a situation where I need to do some stuff. First of all, I need to do it right, and I need to make sure that I need to write from JDOM document the flex, and then I have to write it to my set information object. So let me just do following. I need to this method will work only then after I loaded my flex attributes in the JDOM, not in the JDOM document, but in some sort of a set. So let me just do following. I need to write here following: sorted set integer, and I will write here flex of satellite set reset. This is almost identical as previously, which I have done, and let me just do that. And all right, so I will create getter on setter for this, for the flex, or for my flex I need to create setter, so flex of satellite set. Yeah, this is actually all right, and I need to generate setter and getter for this variable. Okay, and now I need to actually I need to load it. So and this thing which I need to do is actually happens when I'm working with JDOM document here. Let me just do it right. Sat name integer set flex. Assign some value because I need the assignment, and here I use set flex, and here I just need to do almost this. I think this is almost the same stuff. Well, now I need to write here not the name, but the flex, and I need to write here flex. And now I need to parse string to integer. So what I will use, I have a tutorial of my JDOM. Here is the tutorial, and I need just to look it up where he adding value. or I think I can do this in such a way. Let me just think. So I have string. I think I should integer. No, it's actually awkward. String to parse. Wait a second. Let me pause. So let's continue. I need to parse integer, and of course it was a mistake. I admit it. Now I can use this. I can use following. So I'm parsing a string to integer type. In this way, and I need to add the value. It's almost or quite the same stuff. I need to set a flex, get names of satellites, I need to get flex of satellite set and add to the my flex. I add my flex, and of course I have a point here, so this is how it goes. I just adding to the satellites, to the flex of the satellite set, my flex. And when I done so, I need to set it up. I need actually, what I'm actually trying to do, I'm trying to be inefficient, and I'm thinking of that probably the best way to do this method, ask. I need to make sure. Let me just do this in the right way. So I need to verify that my set of flex is not null. And let me do this following flex of the satellite set. I actually need to do like this. Oops, where is my? Yeah, I know this code is getting too large, but this is for me okay. Maybe later I refactor it. So get, I need my flex. Get sorted satellite information set. Wait a second, where is my get flex? And I need to make sure that this set is not null. Not null. Then I return and I return true. In other case, I should return false. And that's it. Maybe the name of the method is a wrong one, because I actually I'm just checking if this is a flex of satellites are set. So I just need to first I execute the test and need to make sure that I'm passing my test. Now I refactor my test. my test. I will refactor my test. Now I need to write here not load, but check if flex from JDocument set. I think this is appropriate. Alright, I need to pause. Let's continue. So I did pass the test and I need to refactor my test. And it should work. And it should work, as you see. So at this point I'm making sure that I'm setting my setInformation object, but this was not quite enough because in the next move I need to think about how to test if my information objects have a flag, and it's quite the same procedure. I need to find the place where I have my constructor. Wait a second. Okay, this is the place. Build. Just reserving the place, not writing code, but reserving the place, reserving a place for the next code. Alright, so now I need to call my set information with a flag. That means following. I need to write set model test. This is actually the same code as here. I'm calling create set information objects. Actually, this is almost the same test, but with one difference that I am. Let me do it separately. I know it looks that I am writing almost the same code, but in my case, check if created set information objects are not null. In my case, this will be actually important to set. Check if created set inform object consist flex. This is what I'm trying to test with this test. And set model object, check if set info object is not null. Let me just write here a method. Check if information set info object flex set. And of course I will fail this test. Let me just execute. Alright, so I'm failing this test and this is okay. So the next move will be to create this method. No. I wish to create a method. Change create a method. So I have this method and I give a true. So I need to pass the test. Now I'm passing the test and now I need to mention here write code. And let me go to the place where I wanted to add some stuff. So where I have written my code, yeah, no, it's getting large. This is what actually to expect from the software, to getting large. So here is a place where I'm having my code. Now let us think what just happening. I need to create, I have an iterator and I need another iterator. Of integers, iterator over set info flex this get flex iterator. This is what I'm actually doing. Integer, and let me do this, do following. So we creating our object, which consists of a name and do I need separate constructor for that? I don't think so, but I think it probably, let's just try it out. An iterator over set flex, and now this will probably fail miserably because we do not have such a constructor. As a result of this, we need to create constructor, and this constructor would have following. It would have string input sat name, and it would have input flex. And you say right now you need to write a test. Right now I need to write a test. I need to write a test for my satellite information. Not a problem. So let me go to my set information test and do this simple test. So I'm just checking following. I need to get a hold of my information object. This will be quite interesting. So what I need to, I just need to call Let me just think about it. Let me just clearly think about. So set info object. So I will need some sort of a mockup. My mockup is here. Private integer flex. Alright, so here I'm writing my flex and just passing some value and passing the value to the constructor, and now I need to, let me just look it. Buckets, satellites, I think it's in satellites. Yeah, okay, okay, number is 1, okay, not a problem at all. So I'm passing my flex into the set info object, and now I need to call my set info object and ask him about the value get, and the value name should be like sat flex. So I actually need to ask get sat flex, get sat flex, and this will be sufficient. And I need to make sure that I am having right assertion and assert not null, getting my value, and I'm making sure that I have something. So what I need to actually do, I go to my set information. I'm writing here private integer setflex, because this will definitely fail right now. When I execute my test, this will definitely fail because I do not have this method. Yeah, failing. And so I need to create getters and setters. So I can set up my field, and here I need just to do almost the same like here, but I need to do this right. Set name, input set name. I need to write here input flex. And should I do it? I should leave it like so. Alright, so things are set up. I'm thinking maybe I break some test, probably. Let's just execute it. Let's just execute it. I'm passing all my tests. Great. So you see, I'm very critical to my own tests, but this is very important to be always critical to write your, when you write your test, because TDD is a tool. It does not guarantee that you will get a very good data structure, but it allows you to refactor your code at any time at point without any additional headaches. So yeah, it's like that. Additionally, I need to refactor some code here. Additionally, I need to put hit not set name, but this get set name, and then I need to put another line like set flex equals to, and then just call this point. Come on, this get set flex, and just write here a new line after that. So this is what I should get when I execute. Where is my test? Not, it is not here. Where I have written my set object should be. At some point, it's all. You must look it clearly without a name. Let me just make it sure that I'm not looking at the right test case. Probably I should use okay. It was very simple thing. So now I just need to write here sys out. I just like to see the output of set object to string when I execute my test. So now I have the situation. So you clearly see that I'm doing the right job. I have one set information object. It has the name, it has the flex, and this is going pretty well. I'm very satisfied with my result. I just uncomment this code and close it up, that I have concentration on more important stuff. So now I can read flex from JDOM document. So this test should work. Let me execute it. Alright, let me pause. So I'm back, and now I have very interesting situation. Some of my tests did fail, so I need to understand why it happened. And after that, my code probably will be even more better. So I have some failing tests. I need to refactor my set model class. So things like that happens, and it's quite interesting to understand why it's happening. So let me just execute JUnit once again. So the first method, test case which failing, read flex from JDOM document. Check if flex from JDOM document set. And what was the error message? Set model. I think I did not yet complete it. Alright. So So here and then wait a second. Does this information get? I'm getting the iterator, which consists of integers. Okay, so this is in pretty interesting. No such element. Sorted satellite set, maybe. Let me just look at sorted satellite set. And I'm adding a set information object. But this should work actually. Set information set. Do I have problems with comparator? No, I don't think so. Other object gets a name. No, it's too strange. But it is interesting. What I have next? No such element exception. No such element exception. So I have done something, I have broke something, but let me just think of so this is quite interesting, man. This is quite interesting. So I'm looking my set model, set information test, it works when I execute the test. Here is a proof that I can work with my information object. This test passing, but my set model test actually broken. So what I have broken? I do not understand it right now. Let me execute it once again. No such element exception. Do create such information object. So am I getting the exception from here? When I execute my create, and now he doesn't like my new set information. I know what the problem is. I did experience it sometime. So this iterator create string, and this iterator and set information. This is pretty strange. Let me just try to do some quick stuff. Let me just look it up. I just think this is actually an int value. It was a value as an int. Let's just execute my test again. No. So this is quite a dilemma for me right now. But you see, if you have such network of, I mean, the net of the test, you can do some interesting stuff. Let me just do it in the way. Let just do it me. Let I delete this. I delete this and this should work right now. Now let's look it up. Ah, okay, so the problem is in my iterator which I'm using to go through to go through my constructor. So I leave it like so that it fail. And this will be definitely fail. Let me just execute it. So it says me that my flex sets is a problematic one, that I have no entries there. And let's make sure that I'm having all things sign up as I expect. So get flex from satellite set. This get flex from satellite set. But where I do setting, where I set up, where I set up the satellite, I need to understand. Ah, okay, so where I'm adding get flex of satellite set and add the set flex. So actually here I'm adding my flex. So let's look at up what. So it should work. Actually, get attribute value flex. It's almost the same problem which I have experienced previously. So I know what I have to do. And let me just pause it. I can later explain what I have done wrong. Alright, people. Once again, I'm persuading that data structures are a very important thing. And so my problem was in following. I did use wrong type of data structure for saving my flex list. Why you say? Because if you look up at the XML, you see that flex can be repetitive. So you can repeat flex one, and different name. So the name of the satellites are different, but the names of the satellites are different and unique, but the flex can be the same. So, and now I have the situation I fix the code. I fix my code. In following, I change the data type. And now, let's just test it once again. I tested it previously, and it did not fail. Now I execute my set model test. All tests passing through. All 9 tests passing through, and I'm clearly see that I have 3 elements in my list of flex. So once again, if you look up this diagram, my flex elements are not unique, and first in first out doesn't matter. And last in first out doesn't matter, so I use actually a list, simple like this. So now when I have done such job, I was puzzled at first, because the year which I got, it was an exception year, but I did not got a clue why it why it's so, but it was the nature of the data structure which I used for saving my values. So now I learned the lesson, and let's continue. So what I should do next? First of all, I need to delete this output. I don't need it, and I'm actually thinking about refactoring this method, but it should stay here for a little bit in this form. I'm actually need to execute all of my test suites, and just to have a feeling that I'm not failing at other tests. So let me just execute all tests and look up. Maybe something goes wrong, maybe not, hope not. Yahoo! It does work. So all 18 tests are going through. And yeah, that was quite an interesting problem. So probably my mistake was I didn't think about the data structure for my flex. So but the next test will be to make sure that I am saving the position right. So write a test, set model test, and let me think through. So I have my set information, and in order to write me the next step, where is it? Oh, it is here. So it would looks almost identical here, but in order to write another set model test, I need to write a test for set information. Let me just do this again, set information test. Now let me just do this in the right format. Test void check if, let's do think about what we should do next. So I need to check if position not null. Simple like that. And I need to reassure that my set position. Let me just look it up. Integer position, that my position is, that my position can be set up. And what I should do next? So integer position, and I should call an object get set info position, get sat position, and I need to do a write assert. So I'm doing the assert, and let me just take this as a value. So quite good. And I can now, the next move will be like to write a position attribute, I mean the field here, like private integer . Okay, now I need setter on getter. Getter on setter at the position, and I need to create this method. Oh, I just under let me just do it. Let's just kill it. I need to rename the variable start position, of course. Here set position, and I need to refactor this. Name. So set position get, and I need to generate getters and setters. So here I need to make sure about set flex. I think I know. Get and set. Have a problem, Houston. I have a problem. So let me just delete it. And I need to create here refactor. So I could get getters and setters for the set flex. So it will work accordingly. Flex. Let's hope this will work. Let's execute the test. And now it should work, and let me just do it in the right format. Now let's just execute the test. Oh. Set informate check if position not null, and that's right. I've forgotten to set up properly my object. Private integer position. I'm setting up a position. I don't know. Let's look it up. Position can be 50, 150. It does not, I mean, the value of the position can be, it have a range. Alright, so I need to modify my constructor. Position. Set information. So I will just here add integer input position, and just need to write here this set position input position. So I did set up my constructor. Of course, another code will break. I now know it. But this is okay. So the position in my test set up. Probably I can execute this test. Let me just do this. All tests pass. So I'm setting up a position. And let's identify what we should write next. So it should fail. Yes, it's failing. Great. Now I need to write a test to pass it. So let's just write a test. I'm writing another test. I think clearly that is of the nature of the test almost the same. This is almost the same as I had created previously. So read. Do I have a read? Probably this is not good. Read flex set model check flex. Probably I will rename it as check flex from JSON document. Check. Check position from JDOM document. So I need to check it. And of course I need to write another method. Check if position from JDOM document set. And this was not created. Let's create it. Create a method. Now I have this method. And now that will be very interesting. I need to pass the test. Hopefully it should pass. But I see. Yeah, it doesn't work, that's right, because I've written new constructor, and I need to do the following. So it's failing. And I see a pattern that I'm having some code which is not covered yet. So I need to pass actually two tests. But it will be very simple. So let me quickly think about what I should do next. So, like I said previously, I need to create an integer. Let me put it like this: position of sternoid list, new array integer. So we have a list with the positions of our satellites, and I need getter on setter. Getter and setter for my position of my satellites list, like this. So I'm setting up the position of my satellite list, and I need to create here. I need actually to check up here my position, set satellite position, and write here value. And the next move will be very pretty simple. Set po, let me just copy the variable name, and then I just need to copy this. And then I need to make sure that I have access to my XML. I need this, and I need this. So, like following, and then I need to write here get position of satellites list add. And I'm then adding actually the value which I'm getting from the XML JDOM document. So it's pretty good. I like the code. Maybe I will refactor it, but let me just do it in such way that it can work for me, first of all. So now I have the situation. I'm reading from the JDOM document. I'm setting up the set information object. And let me just do the building. All right, so I need another iterator, almost the same line, but iterate over sat info position get let me just delete it. So I actually need to get position of the list and call the iterator on it. So, and now I can just here add extra line to do it like so. I need this for I need this to build my set information object. So this was, and now what I have done, I did access the JDOM document, I got from the value, and I did pass this value to my nearly new object which I create. So let me just do this like this, and This should work probably, and I will just do this. I know it looks some sort of ugly right now, but I will later will just refactor it. I can now do it, but I need to do this method. So check if that information set in set info object flex set. I will get the value from, let me just write a construction. So I need to get a value from get flex, and I need get flex of satellites list, and to be sure I need a string. Let me just think what I need to get it to string. So I'm getting an integer, so int I need a iterator retain to string, and then I just need to get is empty, and then I should check it of boolean expression. It's almost, let me just think it. I wrote it once and then I just need to, sometimes it's pretty overwhelming, but I can go through it maybe. I need, okay, it's almost 1 hour. So what I need to do, the question is, what is my thinking process? I am getting an integer, I am creating a string, and I am checking if this string is not empty. So it should, I am getting a boolean expression, so it should be not equals to true. Not equals to true, and when I have this situation, I will get true. Or maybe, wait a second, do I have my logic right? So so what it gets back, so it is true when I getting from is empty is true, otherwise it's false. So if I have a value in my list of flex and this value is some number, then I get as response false not equal to true, so it means that I have got a number. All right, so and I can use the same logic at here, and probably I should refactor this, refactor extract method, check if if a number is provided. Is provided. I think this will be appropriate. And I will rewrite it because integer and I will write here current flag. So now I just need to get hold of it. I know. Sorry. So I working with a list. I'm getting the list. And I'm making sure that the list. So check if that info object flex set. Probably should rename it to the list in my test, set model test. Let me just look it up. So it's quite quite puzzled, this class which I have created, but can be sometimes like this. So set model test. What I'm actually, where I'm calling? Okay. So I know what I have to do. Check if set info object flex set. Check if set object flex list. And right now I need to do this command. I'm getting the integer value. I'm passing this value to the, okay, so now I'm getting to the point where I'm saying that I should think clearly enough. So list integer, because we're working with the list. I'm passing through the list integer. Wait a second, list integer input list, and I call on input list to string. I'm calling actually here. Alright, so I'm calling to string on the input list of string. Wait a second. Probably it should work. What? I don't understand why it doesn't. Because I do it wrongly. So let me just rethink what I'm doing here. So on the input list it should like this. So it was just wrong formatting for me, for my side. Now I have written a method which actually check if a numbers in provided list check if the numbers in provided list are correct. So let me just rename it, right? So I'm checking when I'm getting the list of integers, I make a if condition, and I'm getting two string representation of the list. And if this list is if the list empty, then I get a value true. Then of course it is false, because then means that the list is sorry that I'm bubbling. I mean, if the list is empty, then I return false. Otherwise, it is true, because it is not empty. And what I need here, I just need here to do in a other method almost the same. And what I have to do, current position. I need to get positions, and I need to return. Then I use like this, and I just need to pass it a value. It's almost the same code, but I was quickly to see this, and I just reuse it. And now I shall go to my test, and here I just need to call following. For the flex, I will call let me just copy, this will be simplified solution. So let me check flex list. Oops, wrong place here. Now and oh, this was wrong place. Very long place for that. At the bottom. Here, actually, the code which I need to check it. And wait a second, what was wrong about this? Check if that info object flex set. Ah, of course, sure. Check set flex, and here I think I have broke something in my test suite. Let me just save it. So I need to test, check if position from J document set. Okay, so let me just execute my test. Oh, it's passing. So at this point I need to a little bit clean up my code, because I see something goes wrong. Here's okay, it's pretty obvious what it does, and actually this ugly part of code I need to change it. And let me just refactor like that. So how I should call it? This actually, what it does, it passing values to the constructor. So, and it, I would say it's a finishing construction. I will say it's a builder. No, so it's constructing and adding object to the set info. No, so constructing and adding object. So constructing and adding object. Set info object to the set. Constructing and adding set info object to set. Now it looks definitely better. Let me just do it like this. Yeah, I have a lot of things here going out, so here almost the same, but it is better to read it when it's formatted like so. Okay, let me just save it, and it should pass all of my tests. Set model test, run as JUnit test, and yeah, it passed. So yeah, it was quite tedious at some point, but I did finish it. I did created the tests. My set information object almost complete. I just need to, let me just add here some code. This is just for output. So what I need to add? I need to add set position and just here to write here get position, and I think this will be quite sufficient. So anyway, I have some problems with my data structures at the beginning. Do I have here? I don't need this breakpoint. Just all right. So, what he doesn't like it. The value of the local is not used. So, this can be deleted without any problem. Let me just execute my set model test. It's passing through. Let me execute the test, one test only, where I'm check position from JDOM document rest test, and let me copy one line where I'm printing values result. I think this is the line which I needed. So let me just execute it. Not here, but when I execute this position test, so let me just execute it. Set model get sorted satellite information set to string. Yeah, and it should print me the values for each of the satellites. So, okay. So, you clearly see that I have proper names. I have flex and sat positions. Let's just check it out. So I copy this output to where I have this plugin. I think I have a plugin with the editor. Let just me go and find the editor. Notepad. Notepad for me, for E. So now I just need to put the values. It's a plugin for Eclipse. I probably does not use too much in my work, but it can be quite helpful, as you see now. So satellites. Let me just check the value. So the first object would have the name. This would be the object. Ah, I see. This is actually wrong result. Because I need to put, so the name, the assignment of the values is okay, but the order of the insertion is not okay. Huh. So I did wrong the insertion order. So let me just think about this. Let me pause. Okay, so another milestone at my development of my project following. I did take a time to make my thoughts about what just happened, and I come to conclusion that I used wrong data structure for my names of the satellites. I'm using currently set, so I holding the uniqueness of the names, but the order should be not sorted, but actually I'm expecting to have the insertion of order. So the order is happened through the insertion. I think I had thought a lot, I did think about that I did it prematurely. So this is quite interesting development in my project, but it works. So let's just compare the values. I have my test. Run JUnit test. You clearly see that I'm passing all of my 10 tests. And if you look up the output, let me just show you the output. I copy the output to my editor. And let's just try to compare it with the data which I got in form of XML. Let me just do it in such a way that you can read it. So let's go to the first satellite. You see that I maintain the sorted view, but I used the data structure with the name of linked hash set. Sorry, I misspelled me wrongly. So there's a lot of information how to do the data structure, and you always should compare your thinking pattern with a few people with more experience than you. But this is a quite happens a lot in the practice that you should rethink your data structure. It happens quite a lot, I would say. So what I'm actually currently looking up, I'm looking up code snippet. So additionally, I would like add following. So if I use linked hash set, my order, I continue to maintain my order, but the iteration happens in order of insertion. Iteration happens in the order of insertion, and this all what I need to show you. But you clearly see that it works. So let's just compare the result and just try to something to add, to change something, to get better understanding. Did I get it right or not? So Astra has a satellite with name Astra, is here, Sirius Astra, and you see flex is 1, position 50. That's okay. Now let's look at another satellite name. Once again, name of the satellite Hotbird, and position is 130. So it's clearly showing that I got it right this time. So actual change was just to change the data structure type, which I have used for storing the names of my satellites. And the last one is, I think it's Astra. So this would be like so. So you see clearly this, okay. And now I just need to do some funny thing. I change some values, let's say 6. Let me do it to 20, 150, and let's change here 3 and 10, and here I need to make, I don't know, 2 and 80. So, and if I run the test, it should produce the correct data. Alright, so I've got the data, and let's just compare with the satellite's point XML. Sirius Astra has a value 2, position 80. Hotbird have a flex 3, position 10, name is alright. Astra is 6, position 20, 50. So it was quite, sorry, I drink a cup of coffee. So it was a quite a challenge, and I did puzzled for about half of hour. But I look up in the internet, I did found out about linked hash set. So it's real life situation, I would say. Nothing special at all. But right now I'm just going forward. So I setting up values back, which I have changed. Let me just copy the values. So anyway, it is interesting. It was interesting experience for me. And now the last thing before I end this session, I need to set the values back. and I need to make sure that I am going to, let me just set it up firstly, flex 1, position 50. So this is the previously values which I have changed. Now I run set model test. Let's run it and then compare the values. So let's back to satellites. Sirius is 1, sat position 50. Then Hotbird set flex at 1, position 130. 130. Then I have Astra. Almost need to check it. Astra is have flex 1, position 192. Sorry, I'm thinking like thinking German way of the number, so doesn't matter right now. So anyway, I did succeed, and at another point that my tests helped me anyhow to develop in such a way. Let's just run all of the sets tests which I have written. Let me just do this right away. Now it should continuously run. Oh, I have 20. 0 failures, 0 errors, skipped, no skipping of the test. That's right. And yeah, I'm just getting through my set model class one last time. I probably should I refactor this. So currently I'm using a lot this method, check name of sat and calculate amount. And I need actually to think about it. Actually I need to refactor this into a method. What this method is doing? I would write here a method with the name of read attribute. Now read set info data from JDOM document. I'm actually not reading. It was in the previous. I will copy the name of the method, but it was actually here in this. It was here actually. Here I'm doing this method. Oh, it cannot do. Alright. So I need to create here setting extract method. So I'm actually passing values to my set information. No, to the different types of data in my set model class. I will say preparing the set in or setting up data for set info object. Probably somebody can tell that you can name it better, but this is what I have currently in mind. Let's do this. Let's run the test. I don't need this view. I just need to comment out the line. How, where it is out, ah, here it is. I just comment out this line. So I see that our class, how many lines do I have here? It's the nature of XML. I did thought about to make some sort of separation of this class, but I have strange feeling to refuse it. Why you ask? Because by the definition, set model holds all of the satellite's point XML, and it holds, it creates a set of set information objects, which later I need to work with for my views and other classes. So let me just conclude. The big challenge was in the data structure, as always. I have never seen any projects that they are have prob not didn't have a problems with the data structure. Data structure will be always a challenge, but the good thing about this whole experience is as follows, that tests help me to find something strange things out, some corner cases which actually you cannot find out when you only write a code. But tests are very helpful, and I can always edit my code without any headache, and I think that should be sufficient. Let me just do this like this, and yeah, as I said earlier, this is my pet project, but I hope you see an example, a good example how to use TDD. I mean, I write my tests just to get it through. I do not expect to cover all possible corners of my code, but if my code stays clean and short per methods, I'm trying to keep my methods very short, then it should work. Anyhow, what is matters just to be able to work it through. And this is actually all which I want to say to you. The next thing will be for me to read frequency, symbol rate, polarization type, and fact inner. And then I will probably done with my set information and set model classes. But this I would make in another coding session. So I hope you saw something good, and if you like it, what I have written, just comment. If you like, you can subscribe. And see you later. Till the next. Good luck. Bye bye.